ground zero. The number is screened tonight, 877-733-1011. That's 877-733-1011. In this time of the first hour, we gave a rundown of historic treaties. We basically have made the INF Treaty toast. That's a, you know, good way of putting it, because, you know, we just tested some missiles yesterday off the coast of California. Russia tested a new rocket, and apparently it killed several of their scientists and sent a spike of radiation through the area. People say it was a nuclear device that exploded. But there are other treaties that certainly make you wonder if we're negating those and avoiding them. One in particular is the space treaties that were established in 1967, where we were saying back then that we didn't want to turn space into a battlefield. And Vice President Pence announced today that Space Command is going to be in effect next week. Okay, so we're going to have Space Command ready to go. That's Space Force, for those of you that don't know that they changed the name to Space Command. So Space Command will be ready to go next week, which once again opens up the questions to whether or not we're turning the space above us into a battlefield. And whether or not all along we've turned into a battlefield, you know, SDI, Star Wars, INF, you know, all these things that we've been abandoning over the years because we want to actually turn space into a dumping ground for nuclear waste and you know, nuclear weapons of mass destruction. It's interesting that India's Chandrayaan-2 moon mission has now entered, or at least impregnated, orbit yesterday. They're orbiting the moon. The orbital insertion was completed. That happened yesterday, August 19th, at about 11:32 p.m. So, according to the statement from the Indian Space Research Organization, which runs the Chandrayaan-2 mission, they want to report the procedure was successful and the mission was on track to set its lander down on the moon early next